let us discuss about projection of spaceships and satellites from Earth. We know well that in the surrounding of Earth, if we wish to make a body as a satellite, then we need to project it with such a speed that its gravitational force will provide the necessary centripetal force for the circular motion. Say if this Earth having mass ME and say its radius is RE, and say from Earth center at a distance x there is a circular orbit, and we wish that a body should orbit around the Earth in this circular path, then from the Earth's surface a body has to be taken to the respective height and we throw it with the orbital speed V naught such that it will revolve in the circular orbit. And we already discussed that the orbital speed is given as root of g ME by x. Now, if a body is to be thrown in such a way that very close to Earth's surface, it is orbiting in air, or you can say it is orbiting in the space surrounding of Earth, very close to Earth's surface, or you can say we just take if x is approximately equal to RE, then in this situation here we can see if x is equals to RE or this very close to Earth's surface, then here we can see the orbital speed will become, it is root of g ME over RE. And we know that g ME by RE square can be written as gravity on surface of Earth. So it can be written as root of gs RE. If we substitute the value of gravity at Earth surface and the radius of Earth, this will be approximately, it is 7.93 kilometers per second. This is the speed with which when a body is projected just above the Earth's surface in a tangential direction, it will orbit, it will start orbiting around the Earth's surface without falling onto Earth. And this velocity is also termed as first cosmic velocity, the velocity with which a body can be thrown from Earth's surface such that it will not fall back on Earth, it will orbit around the Earth. Or any velocity with which a body is thrown such that it won't come back on Earth is called cosmic velocity. So if this is the minimum speed with which when a body is thrown tangentially, it will start orbiting around the Earth as a satellite very close to Earth's surface and it won't fall back. So we can simply state this is the speed with which when a body is thrown near to Earth's surface, it will move on a circular orbit. There can be many other possible orbits depending on the projection speed. Let's carry on the next section. And as we already discussed in the previous sections that the velocity required to escape from gravitational attraction of Earth is, this already we have discussed, that is about escape velocity. It is given as V escape can be written as, we already studied, it is root of twice of GSRE, which is equals to 11.2 kilometers per second. Here you can see this is the velocity which is root 2 times the orbital speed, as orbital speed is root of GSRE. So we can say if body is orbiting around the Earth in a circular orbit close to Earth's surface, then if its velocity is made root 2 times, that will escape. That is a general phenomena we already discussed for escaping of a satellite in its circular orbit. Now on the next slide, we'll discuss about different type of trajectories which are possible when a body is projected from a point in the surrounding of Earth. Now let's continue our discussion on trajectory of projected bodies. Here this Earth and various dotted paths show various kind of trajectories depending on the projection speed. Say from Earth's surface a body is taken to a position in a space and is tangentially thrown with a speed V. As we have already discussed, if the projection speed is equal to orbital speed, then the body will follow a circular path. In previous section, one of the previous section we have discussed that if the speed is less than the orbital speed required for circular motion, then it will follow an elliptical trajectory with Earth's center located at the farthest foci of the ellipse. And if the speed is more than V naught, or if a speed is more than the orbital speed, the outer ellipse is obtained and Earth's center will be located at the nearest foci of this ellipse. Now let's discuss what will happen if V is equal to escape velocity. Here we can see if V is equals to V escape. In that situation, we know well that if a body is thrown with escape velocity, it will not come back on Earth, or it will be able to overcome the Earth's attractive forces. So obviously the path will be unbounded and it will move. And this path will be a parabolic trajectory. And in a parabolic trajectory, the body will move away and it will reach to infinite. And it will not come back again onto the Earth's surface. Similarly, if V is more than V escape, if the body is thrown with a speed more than escape velocity, then it will follow a hyperbolic trajectory. And again, as speed is more than escape velocity, the total energy of the body at the position from which it was projected is more than zero or positive, then we can directly state that it will be able to overcome the Earth's attraction. So, the equations of these trajectories, whether elliptical, circular, again elliptical, parabolic or hyperbolic, are obtained by just the coordinate analysis of the motion of particle under the influence of inverse square force of Newton's law of gravitation. I hope you can recall that in dynamics we have studied that whenever a body moves under the influence of a central force which follows inverse square law, different type of trajectories can be obtained depending on the motion velocity of the body, which are the different trajectories of conic section, or with the trajectories which are the different curves of conic section. A similar situation is arising over here, that various trajectories of the projected body in the gravitational field of Earth are basically the various trajectories which are the curves of conic section depending on the projection speed.